Well, it's an honor to be here today. I got started in the airlift right after it started. Came over from Alabama, and I thought it was going to be over right away. Stalin was getting a black eye in the world press, starving 2 million people. They started saying, hey, maybe this communism is not such a good idea after all. So I thought it was going to quit soon. That's how dumb I was. So just in the beginning, I thought it's going to be over. Soon it's over. They're going to send me home. I won't get any pictures of downtown Berlin. You have to stand right by the airplane when you unload that stuff. The second that last sack of flowers off, you had to get the engines going and go back for another one. So we couldn't see anything. So when I landed in Berlin, went from Berlin to Rhein-Main in Frankfurt one day. I was supposed to go to bed about noon and start flying that night. But I wanted to go get to Berlin so I could look around a little bit. My buddy was starting engines with the loaded dried potatoes next to me on the hard stand. So instead of going to bed, I jumped and grabbed my movie camera, got in the airplane, and went to Berlin. Hiked around the barbed wire fence, where the airplanes were landing, and right on the other side of the barbed wire, wearing a uniform just exactly like this, 30 kids came up the barbed wire, talked to me in their school English, did well. And for an hour, they were cheering me up, telling me how grateful they were. They didn't have enough to eat. It was tougher then because they cut off the food than it was even a few months earlier, or a year earlier. They had all their food cut off. They said, look, it's July. The weather's good. Wait till winter, and it's going to be snow and ice. You can't get in here in the winter very often. When that happens, don't worry about us. We don't have to have enough to eat. Just don't give up on us. Someday we'll have enough to eat. We lose our freedom, we'll never get it back. Kids, 8 to 14, teaching me in America about how important freedom was. Hitler's past. And Stalin's future coming at him. He wanted West Berlin and West Germany. It was their nightmare. They knew what it was like. Their aunts and uncles walked across the border. Don't want anything to do with those guys. They were friendly. And I say, I spent too long, got to run. I have a Jeep waiting for me to take the picture. I started to run. Little voice said, oh, they're incredible. How come? Well, they know what's important in life. They got their values straight. And I started to walk. Wrong answer. It bothered me so much, I stopped. Then get to the Jeep, but that little voice stopped. And then I knew immediately what it was. During World War II and after, walking down a street in foreign countries, this uniform, the kids in that age would chase you and grab you by the hand. Give me chocolate, give me chocolate. Even though they had some. These kids hadn't any for years on an organized basis, except the GIs sharing with them. Like our good friend Earl, what a hero he is. I've heard about him on the live and just met him a couple of days yesterday. That idea that hit me that they're so grateful, and that's a magic word in whatever you do in your life, that breaks down the walls between people, between families, between nations, in everybody. With gratitude, it opens a two-way street to magnify the talents that each individual has, and make 2 + 2 = 6. So that gratitude, when I realized they were so grateful for flour to be free, they wouldn't beg for more. Freedom was the element, and they wouldn't ask for pennies, which chocolate would have represented. When I realized that, and never the other kids chase you for it, and these kids had none, I got to do something, wished I had some, reach my pocket, and all I had was 2 sticks of Wrigley double mint gum. 30 kids would have a fight, get out of here. And I started to leave, and then I said, I'll never see them again. I couldn't get back the fence, I'd be flying 24 hours without sleep, couldn't get back for a week, wouldn't see these same kids again. So give it to him. Turned around, went back, broke 2 pieces in half, 4 pieces through the barbed wire, and the people with a half a stick looked like he got $100 immediately. And and the other kids come rushing out, so they don't fight. They didn't. They wanted a piece of the wrapper. The guys with a half a stick tore off the outer wrapper of the tinfoil and passed out this slim piece of paper. And those that got it held it up their nose. And they smelled the aroma, just the sweet aroma. And smelled a piece of the wrapper, and their eyes got big. And I stood there dumbfounded. And that's how it started.